Welcome to Talk of the Town. I'm Lauren Real, and we have a great show for you today. We're going to be checking in with Connie Safety, learning about keeping you safe at work, talking with one of our news partners, the Madison Community Montessori School, and finally learning about a great program going on in the Madison area at Wild East Town Honda. But first, I have Alicia Fisher from Texture Salon. How are
yes,
you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thanks good. For joining us.
Thank
I'm
you
so
for
glad
having
to have you
me.
On. You're very welcome. So I know the first thing that I noticed when I went to Texture is it is just a beautiful, beautiful salon. So let's
Thank
talk
you.
A little bit about how does the guests feel when they walk into the salon? What do you want them to feel like?
It's kind of one of those, actually, when you walk into Texture, it's more of a sense of relief
yeah.
because you walk in and you know that you're going to be well taken care of.
Mm-hmm.
So we are meticulous down to, you know, what we offer you to drink, salon tours. Our staff, you know, they listen, they hear you, and they're able to execute it. So it's just kind of like a breath of fresh air.
Yeah, like you can kind of let go of anything going on in your day, any stresses,
Absolutely.
And you walk in and you just know you're going to be well taken care
exactly.
of.
Exactly.
I think that's so important. And that's such an important part of someone's day. It's just taking that time to relax and take care of yourself and do something like your hair or get a manicure or whatever it may be.
It is. And we're really old school traditional too. We don't allow cell phones in the salon because we really want people to have that time to relax and focus on themselves. So.
And just check out mentally from anything else.
Absolutely.
Because it's so hard to unplug sometimes
it
and
is.
Stop answering those emails, whatever it may be.
It really is.
Well, I commend you for that. That's wonderful.
Thank you.
Maybe I need to stop by. I think I could use some of that in my
right?
life. So, other than that, what will they experience that's different from any of the other local salons?
So really, what our main focus is continuing education for our stylists.
Mm-hmm.
So it's so important because we bring educators in from all over the U.S. and we train our staff in the latest trends. And not just the latest trends, it's making it so that they're able to create a look that actually fits your lifestyle. And so that way you can replicate it at home and have something that's really suited just to you.
So they're always fresh. They're always learning more and more and more
exactly.
about what they do.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's so great, too. And I think it keeps everybody on their toes a little bit. It constantly gives your clients new options and they can
Absolutely.
Tailor even more individually
mm-hmm.
to what
exactly.
they need. So that definitely sounds like you've got some fantastic designers. What makes them a step above any other designers in the area?
Really, it's their ability to listen. It's
mm-hmm.
their ability to educate our clients. One of the things that is not a compliment for us to hear is actually, oh, I can never style hair the way that you do. And for me and for my staff, it's one of those where we want you to be able to do it.
Yeah.
So we walk you through step by step. This is how you do it. These are the tools that you actually need, and making sure that they understand exactly what it is that they're doing. And then we send them home with an outline. Like, this is actually how you do it. These are the steps that you need to take. So that way they can take and do it at home and have that same look that they would in the salon every
that.
Day.
I mm-hmm. love that. That's so fantastic. And I know that that's definitely happened to me before. And I'm like, gosh, it just doesn't look the same.
Right.
And I think that's great that you say, instead of wanting them to, you know, feel that way. You want them to feel like, hey, I can replicate this. This is
Absolutely.
Wearable. This is something that I can do for myself at home. And that's going to keep them coming back and
it does.
Having that wonderful experience.
It really does.
To you. Wow. Great, great, great. So you talked a lot about education. You guys focus quite
yes.
a bit on education. How does that impact the guests? You know, what does that translate over in the guest experience?
So really the kind of the biggest focus with continuing education is so that we have all of the information
mm-hmm.
and all of the knowledge that we can possibly get, so that way the client knows that they are taken care of, that we're able to share that knowledge in a manageable way for them, that
yeah.
they know, like, okay, this is what I'm here for, this is the expectation that I have, this is the service I'm going to receive, and they have like this comfort and this consistency knowing that they're always getting the best.
Wow, that's fantastic.
Thank
I love
you.
That. So that kind of goes right along with, what is your mission at Texture? Is that kind of right in line with that?
It is. Really, our mission is to inspire creativity.
Mm-hmm.
So not just in our designers, but actually in our clients.
Yeah.
So it's really an environment where we harvest creativity, and we recognize that what we do, it is such an art, and we give women confidence. Well, men and women alike.
Exactly, exactly.
We give them confidence so that they can go out and do what they want to do, and they know that they look it, that they have like that certain edge that's unique just to them.
Well, that's so true. And, you know, speaking of a certain edge, I think everyone at home as well as myself,
yeah.
we can't notice but your amazing hair.
Yes.
This is so fun. I love it. I love
Thank
it.
You.
So I've seen some of these bright colors lately, but they look so good. They're so wearable every day. Is that one of the hottest trends for fall this year?
Yes. It's actually considered traditional rebel. So
traditional
it's basically
rebel.
Taking, so mine's a lot. So I mean, it's bright pink everywhere.
It's in your face, but I love it.
Thank
I love
you.
It.
But kind of what they're doing is they're taking taking in, they're transitioning these fun styles or these fun colors into something that's really wearable, you know, for the busy mom, the career woman. You can still have that, but in a very, you know, you can go completely avant-garde like mine, or you can have it in a more subtle way that's extremely wearable. So,
get a little fun, but then still go to work and do
exactly.
your thing.
Exactly.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Alicia. It was wonderful talking to you and learning all about texture.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with more Talk of the Town. Welcome back to Talk of the Town. Joining me now is Marty Daly from Connie Safety Products. How are you today?
I'm doing wonderful, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Oh, absolutely, pleasure to have you on. So let's talk a little bit. I know that Connie Safety's been around in the Madison area for a long time, right? It's 60 years?
Right,
is that
that's correct, yes.
Wow, that's impressive. So tell me a little bit about what you do and what types of products and services you specialize in.
Oh, absolutely. So Connie Safety started as a family company, as you mentioned, 60 plus years ago.
Very impressive.
And very exciting. And even before OSHA, and those of you that don't know, the Occupational Safe and Healthy Health and Safety Board that oversees and regulates a lot of the requirements to keep workers safe in the workplace started in 1970. And so Connie Safety predated that. And in 1970, when the regulations and things started to catch up, Connie was already in business providing safer work environments, right?
Mm-hmm.
So quite a bit ahead of the curve. So an exciting time. And really what we do is we provide safer work environments.
Yeah.
So anything from hard hats to earplugs, to eyewear, things of that nature.
And that's incredibly important and definitely not something that should be forgotten. So
right. Well, it's
wonderful.
Important to keep people safe at work.
Certainly, certainly. So it's another thing, other than being around for 60 years already, Connie Safety is a lot larger than I realized. You guys have a parent company, Wesco Distribution, based out of Pittsburgh, correct? So why is Connie based in Madison?
Well, first of all, Madison's amazing. And I think
I would agree.
Right? And myself being a transplant, I relocated with my family here about 2 years ago, just based on the opportunity. So as you take a look at Madison, you take a look at the workers and the environment and the sustainability of a town like this, and you look at a company like Connie that's been in this market for over 60 years, it makes sense to stay put. We're very focused on continuing to support the community and continue to expand the business. As you look at Wesco, as you mentioned, it's an $8 billion company with locations across the United States. 9 full-service distribution centers across the United States, and Madison and Connie Safety is one of those distribution centers.
Well,
so it's a long-term part of the Wesco enterprise.
Yeah, that's very important. And I think especially you'd probably agree with Madison, it's just been growing and growing and growing. New apartments, new restaurants, new businesses left and right. So hopefully you're not getting bored over here.
No, we're not. Actually, in the last year and a half, we've added 70-plus people into the business and built out the sales organization. So we're always constantly looking for new talent. And it's an exciting environment to work in.
So in that same vein, let's talk a little bit about what the future has in store for Connie Safety.
Sure. Well, as I mentioned, we continue to expand our field sales organization. We're expanding into our safety services business, so our capability to get out and to deploy solutions across the United States and even North America, utilizing Madison as a center of excellence for safety products is really what we're after and where we're headed.
So let's talk a little bit to the viewers at home and to any of the companies listening out there. Why should they care about safety? What makes Connie stand out and what you do for them in a safety fashion?
Yeah, well, that's a great question. I mean, at the end of the day, we get up and go to work every day so that we can come home and be with our families. And that's
really
what Connie Safety does, is provides the products to keep workers safe when they go to work so they can come home at night. So whether it's climbing inside a grain bin or working on a construction site, if you're climbing into a small area, confined space, there could be noxious gases, things along those lines. We provide the equipment that keep people safe so that they can come home at night and spend that time with their families.
I love that, because those are jobs that are going to get done, and a lot of jobs there's always that little bit of a danger factor, but you're mitigating that as much as possible and making families feel comfortable that their loved ones are safe at work and you're taking care of them.
Well, it's exciting to think about coming to work every day and being able to help other people out in
their
lives. And not every company can say that that's what they do
every day. It's very rewarding, isn't it?
It's great.
So let's talk a little bit about some of the challenges that you're facing at Connie. What are the biggest challenges in your marketplace right now?
Well, I think everyone would agree when you're in the industrial space like we are, the economy's challenging right now. We're not getting a lot of help. I joke around with the team that you either have headwinds or you have tailwinds.
Yeah.
We have a lot of headwind right now, so it's challenging. We're out there working every day to take market share and to expand the knowledge that people have around safety products and the importance of keeping environments safe for workers. One of the great things about a business like ours is safety will always be a topic of conversation.
Absolutely.
Regardless of where business goes.
Oh, that's going to be there every single day, day in and day out.
Absolutely.
So you'll be around for a long time to come. Yeah,
that's the plan.
So real quick, we've just got time for one more question.
Sure.
Are you guys hiring, and what talent might you be looking for a viewer listening at home?
Right. Well, thank you for asking that question. We're always hiring talented people. We're always looking for people within the sales organization as well as marketing, as I mentioned, product management, supplier relations, folks that are really up-and-comers and want to have a lot of focus on their career in the future.
And be part of that growth that you're talking about. Well, thank
Absolutely.
You very much, Marty Daly
Absolutely.
From Connie Safety Products. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Talk of the Town.
Thanks for having me.
Welcome back to Talk of the Town. Joining me now is one of our news partners, Vicki McCarthy from the Madison Community Montessori School. How are you today?
Great. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Great to have you on again. So today we're going to talk a little bit about Montessori in the home.
Right.
So I know for you guys, you start doing schooling for kids 12 months and older, correct?
Right.
So if a family maybe wants to start implementing that Montessori philosophy really early on, what can they do in their own home to implement that?
Right. Well, when a baby first comes home, it's mm-hmm. a time of transition for everybody, for the baby, for the family. Even if it isn't the first baby, it's always a time of transition. So those first 6 weeks, 6-8 weeks, are really, really an important time
Very crucial,
for family
definitely.
To do bonding mm-hmm. and for the home environment really to be as calm and peaceful as possible.
I know. I'm sure you want to do anything you can to smooth that transition
right.
and make it easy for the family, right. easy for the newborn.
Easy for sleep, if that's at all possible.
Yes. That is the goal, right?
That is the goal.
Hope. So if you're setting up a nursery for your newborn or, you know, your baby you just brought home, what sort of things should a new parent keep in mind to bring into that nursery?
You know, I think less is more. Mm-hmm. There are so many things out there available for babies,
mm-hmm.
and there are only so few
yeah,
things that
included?
Are really needed.
What should be included?
So you need a physical changing mm-hmm. area where you're going to be able to change the baby's diapers and the baby's mm-hmm. clothes, and everything should be in arm's reach, because when the baby's that little, you don't want to walk away from
yeah,
the baby.
Not even for a second.
Not even for a moment. Mm-hmm. So that's the first area you want to establish. And the second area would be a feeding area. So maybe a comfortable chair for mom to do nursing or feeding in the baby's room with a step stool or something in a little table for her personal
yeah,
items nearby.
Something to make that very comfortable.
Right, because there's a lot of time spent feeding a baby.
Oh, I bet. Mm-hmm. I bet. It's definitely mm-hmm. a full-time job.
Right.
So, second area you'd mentioned was for feeding. What's
right.
the third area? I bet there needs to be a place for the baby to sleep.
Right. And so when a baby is very little, oftentimes families will use a bassinet
mm-hmm.
or a basket such as this for a baby to sleep in when they first come home from the hospital. And then oftentimes when a baby's maybe 2 or 3 months old and a little bit older for the basket, maybe a little bit too big for the basket,
yeah.
oftentimes families move into a crib. And if you're trying to do Montessori in a home environment, I would encourage you to try putting the mattress actually right on the floor
oh, really?
And not using the crib at all.
Okay.
And that is just
yeah,
to really increase the baby's independence to allow
so
the baby to
They're
move.
Encouraging to kind of explore
right.
outside of the
right.
mattress and see
right.
what's going on in the room.
Right.
And I bet that's kind of to enhance their curiosity and help
right.
them build that.
Right, to pique that interest and to really allow that baby the freedom of movement.
Oh, absolutely. That's a really unique idea. I'd never mm-hmm. heard of that before.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool.
Saves a little bit of money, too.
Well, hey, there you go. Another perk of that, huh? So let's talk a little more. Is there a fourth area for
the
setting up a nursery?
The fourth area, yes, is called a movement area.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll want to have, like, a foam mat on the floor or maybe just a thick blanket, something to protect the baby's head. And if you hang like a door mirror horizontally near that mat, then the baby can maybe spend some time awake on its tummy in
sure.
front of the mirror, and that mirror gives the baby a lot of feedback about its movements and the world around him.
Oh.
So it's a really great place to have the baby while it's awake.
This is just one of my personal questions. At what age do babies start to kind of notice that that's them back in the mirror
yeah.
and know they're getting that
months.
Feedback.
Yeah,
okay.
not for a few months.
That's very fun. And I noticed you brought quite a few items with you today. So
right.
can you talk to us a little bit about those?
Yes. So when a baby is really little, and I'm thinking around 2 or 3 months
mm-hmm.
of age, you're trying to develop it three different senses, the visual sense, the tactile sense, and the auditory sense. So when you use something like a mobile, so I'm going to just show one here. This is a mobile that we often use in a Montessori environment. And the idea is that it's really simple.
Mm-hmm.
There are only 3 or 5 elements hanging from a mobile. That's
sure.
about all that the baby needs in terms of stimulation. And you hang a mobile about 10 or 12 inches above the baby's chest, not directly above the baby's face. And that'll really help the baby learn to do some visual tracking.
You know, and I think there's so many out there that have a lot of bells and whistles, and just they can maybe almost be overwhelming to a baby. But this looks like a really simple, peaceful toy to just kind of get them started and start having them engage with the world.
Absolutely.
So I noticed you brought a couple other things. Are there any other toys you might recommend for a newborn?
Yes, absolutely. So for tactile, this is a ball with protrusions. It's very easy for the baby to hold on to this.
Lots of places for them to grab.
And as they get older, this is a great
teething tool.
This is called a grasping beads. It's an easy one to make at home. These are just wooden beads on a leather strap. Again, lightweight, easy for the baby to hold on to.
And these are very simple, too, or maybe even something you could craft in your own home for your newborn.
Absolutely. And lastly, just an auditory, some rattles. This is a gourd. So it's just a dried gourd. Yeah. It's very simple, very lightweight. And then the silver rattle.
I like that. You keep it very simple and easy and clean.
Absolutely.
I love it. Well, it was wonderful talking to you today. Thanks. We look forward to having you on next time. Stay tuned for more Talk of the Town. We'll be talking about a great program going on right here in our community. Welcome back to Talk of the Town. Joining me now is Chad Wotyszak from Wild East Town Honda, and he is working on a wonderful community outreach program called KidSafe. Well, thank you for joining us today.
It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So let's talk a little bit about KidSafe. Can you tell the viewers at home what the program entails?
Sure, absolutely. So Operation KidSafe, it's a outreach event that's there to help the families and the parents of the community. So basically what it is, there's a program that started many years ago by Mark Bott. He's the founder of Operation KidSafe, and the program is, it provides a bio document for children and their families, just in case of a family emergency. They can provide that document to the authorities.
And they do fingerprinting, is that correct?
So that is correct.
They've got documentation of that?
Exactly.
But it's all confidential, and they don't keep anything on record?
Correct.
Okay, perfect, perfect.
Yeah.
So, from what I understand, this is the first time that KidSafe is coming to the Madison area.
That is correct.
And you guys are the lucky folks that are hosting it, so that's wonderful.
Yeah.
So why did Wild East Town Honda choose to get involved in this program?
So we chose to get involved with the Operation KidSafe program because Wild Automotive has been in business for 75 years. And part of what we like to do is give back to the communities that we serve.
Excellent.
So the Madison community is a community that we serve, and so we wanted to be able to provide something to the families of Madison.
And good for you guys. I think that's always great to get involved and show that, you know, you're not only focused on one thing, you want to be involved with the community as a whole and partner with great programs like this. So
absolutely,
I'm sure everybody appreciates you hosting the program and being part of KidSafe. So let's talk a little bit about what parents might need to do to get their kids involved in the KidSafe program.
Sure. So the program, it's completely free, and it's something that we don't need to have anybody jump through any flaming hoops, or they don't have to test drive a car or anything. I mean, it might be fun to watch someone jump through a flaming hoop.
Yeah, I mean, I might enjoy that, but no requirements, huh?
No requirements.
No obligations. No.
So basically, a trusted adult, a guardian, can bring their child to our dealership, and then what we'll do is we'll have them go through the process, we'll do the fingerprinting, we'll take a picture of them, and then we'll provide all the documentation to them. And there's no, we don't do any sort of archiving of the data. We don't store any of that.
Right. That's what I had read as well, and I think that's really excellent. Should give parents that extra layer of comfort.
Right.
Well, very cool. So for everyone at home, totally free. Just come down to Wild East Town Honda and you can get involved in KidSafe. So that's awesome.
Great.
I love that. So what will parents get with the program and with the bio document?
So what they'll get is they'll get a sheet of paper, a nice heavy cardstock paper that has a picture of their child. It'll have their digital fingerprints, and then it'll have a space where they can complete the information about their child. Again, we don't store any of the information, so they can write it in there for their child. And then on the back side, there's a family action safety plan. So if something were to happen, they know what to do.
Oh, like what steps to take and what resources they have.
Yep.
Wow, fantastic.
And then they take that document if something happens and they can give it to the authorities.
Oh, okay. Good to know. Well, that makes it very user-friendly and you know exactly what to do. So that's great. So I know you had said you guys have been around 75 years. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
You like to get involved with the community. So why did, you know, why are you guys putting on this program?
So again, I mean, the main thing for us is just to give back to the community. To us, the way we look at this program is if there's even one child that is saved from something happening, we find it as a success.
Yeah, it's that, more than worth it, more
absolutely,
than worth it.
Absolutely,
absolutely. Oh, I love that. And so let's talk a little bit more. I know you said what is included for parents, but from what I understand, you guys are going to have a lot of fun activities for the kiddos, too, to make this a fun event. You know, I know this might be a little bit of a nerve-wracking topic, but you guys want to make this a fun experience for everybody and make the kids want to get involved.
Absolutely.
So you've got bouncy houses, is that right?
We do. So we have ZooZort, so they're going to be bringing in some exotic animals for the kids to pet.
Really?
Absolutely. We're going to have a bouncy house. We're partnering with Kix Unlimited, so they're going to provide a free demonstration on karate demonstration for self-defense.
How neat.
We have Abra Auto Body coming out, and they're going to do an airbag demonstration. We're going to be doing CPR demonstrations. We're going to be doing face painting, so we're going to be providing a lot of activities. And those are on the both
this is
Saturdays.
It's an all-day event, huh?
It is. It's a little bit of a project. So it's
That's
going
great.
On two full days on the Saturday the 19th and Saturday the 26th.
Well, and I'm sure the families and the kiddos appreciate that, too. You're making that fun and engaging for all members of the family.
Yeah, absolutely.
So real quick, we've just got a couple seconds left, but could you tell us what else is going on during Safety Week, September 19th through September 26th?
Sure. So in addition to those events on the 19th and the 26th, throughout the week, we're going to be having things going on at the dealership. Not nearly as exciting, but we'll have it where the kids can do helmet decorating. Uh-huh. They can do, they can design their own safety sign, in which case we'll do a drawing at the end of the week, and then we'll be giving out some prizes. So we've partnered with local businesses, like the local Starbucks is going to be giving us some items to give away, and then the local Culver's
local
as well.
Culver's.
Yeah,
oh, so snacks, drinks, and lots of fun all week long.
Yep.
So. That sounds wonderful. Make sure you guys go check out KidSafe at Wild East Town Honda. Thanks for coming on, Chad. It was great talking with you today. Thank you for joining us this week on Talk of the Town, and I will see you all next week.